star.
Yo, what's up, man? Zion Aku, Zoom in the house.
Yeah, right now you're with Voodoo Magazine.
Check in. Because when we were Zion I, it's like I was Zion. The name of the group was Zion I, and it was Amp Live. So a lot of time making music, people thought I was Zion I. And then it was like, I'd say Ample's name on almost every song.
Everybody's like,
cat still wouldn't get it. Yeah. I just chose that name just so I could do others. I don't really care what people call me. It doesn't matter.
Where did it come from?
Zumbi is the name of, he's like a revolutionary leader in like, slavery in Brazil still, like in the 1800s. He was like the last leader. It was called the Quilombo, which is a free territory for the slaves and indigenous. Even white people would go up there. Like anybody who wasn't with the slavery system would go up and live free in the Quilombos. And Kahumbi was like the last leader of the Quilombo. Was there for like 200 years. They resisted all these like Europeans, Portuguese, Dutch, English trying to come and conquer them. I don't think the English, Dutch, and Portuguese tried to conquer them. They held them off for like 200 years, basically on guerrilla tactics and like spiritual practices and like capoeira and stuff like that. At least that's what it moved. That's what happened. But yeah, he just represents like resistance, rebellion, staying like really true to who you are and just holding firm in yourself, to me. You know what I'm saying? So he's like an inspiration for me. Well, to me, the Bay Area, I wasn't born here, but I've been living here for a long time. To me, the Bay Area is like, it represents cultural diversity. It represents like fusions of styles that come from the East, that come from Far East, and kind of merges on the West Coast. And I think the Bay Area does it very well. It's like a place where everything synthesizes and mixes together. And along with that, there's a definite consciousness here that I feel like our music, when we came out here from Atlanta, people just naturally kind of took to it because I felt like it was the kind of message that we would resound here anyway. You know what I'm saying? It's like something uplifting, something for people. And also like the political background here also, it just gives groundation to what we do. I feel like we were kind of already on that vibe before we even got here with the music. But since we came here, it's just all together as one thing. You know what I'm saying? The Bay has definitely influenced us in terms of like being like holding really true to hip hop culture. Cause here, it wasn't always the most popular thing. Now it's been going cool since like the mid 90s or so, but it always hasn't been like hip hop in the Bay. Like it's always been a struggle for hip hop on the West Coast. And I feel like that's another thing that just fits us to a T. Well, I mean, we were kind of like weird in Atlanta too, cause we didn't.
Just all around weird everywhere.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah. A little bit. We just don't fit in the box, which, you know, As a youth, I thought that was a bad thing. But as I matured, I realized that was much better to be outside of the box. You know what I'm saying? So we're in Atlanta, we're doing music, we got signed to a major label, blah, blah, blah. It didn't work out. There's four of us in the group. Two guys went and did their own thing. Started selling dope and whatever. One kid, we moved back to the projects. And me and Amp kept making music, we called it Zion 9. And that, the vibe in Atlanta was more like rootsy, like Outkast and all them, the Atlanta hip hop scene hadn't blown up yet.
Yeah.
It's kind of like very like bounce music, like back in the day. So we were down there before it was like at Hotlanta where everybody like T.I., Jeezy is before that, you know what I'm saying? And basically when we left is when it started to blow up. So when we left, we were used to all like the rough and tumble, just do it your own way, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of like punk rock where you just do it yourself. So when we came here, the movement here was already kind of, the independent movement was up and running for 15 years already. So it was like the perfect place for us to come.
And I don't know if...
I said that?
No, yeah, you said that. I mean, as a Turk, yeah. So I wanted to know if, as an artist who's also human, how do you feel, that esoteric understanding your relationships or just channeling of music is... working towards you, your benefit, or against you, or?
Well, I would definitely say it's working towards my benefit. When I say esoteric, I mean just really giving myself space and not tripping off the outside world at all, you know what I mean? Like, okay. It's more like an internal alchemy type of process. I'm just on my shit, you know what I'm saying? Because it's the music I make, so I help craft, I help make it. So I feel like the most important thing any artist can give is like their truest self or the deepest part of themselves, you know what I'm saying? So that's basically what I'm trying to speak to, is giving myself that quiet silence that I need, you know what I mean, to go in, find something unique, and then pull it out and show the world, instead of like just looking around and being fascinated by everything around me, being like, oh, I'm gonna do that, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to like just do my thing, man, because there's everybody else doing theirs, you know what I'm saying? That's the balance of it all. Like, I was explaining to somebody yesterday, it's basically you go on tour and then you break from touring so you can create records when you go back on tour. That's the kind of like art formula, at least. So not being on the road, having that time to just sit in the studio, meditate, do whatever you gotta do, work out, chill up, whatever, to stay in a good positive mental frame of mind, you know what I mean? Like, whatever you need to do that is important, because if you're the dopest, whatever, musician on the planet, but your mental state is incorrect, I mean, I don't know how long the success is gonna last, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like it's more important to be happy, and then I feel like you can do a better job than to do a good job and be unhappy, you know what I'm saying?
So like, do you meditate?
Yeah.
The science of breathing? The Science of Breath,
yeah.
On the blog. That's the radio show, or it's just
a bunch of... It's a radio show I do. It's also, I got a series of like 4 or 5 mixtapes. But right now, predominantly, it's the radio show.
Did you call it, is a reference towards the Oriental philosophy?
Yes, that book. It's named Yogi.
It's Yogi Matcha.
Rama Shaka or something?
Rama Charaka.
Yeah, that guy.
Yeah, his book.
Yeah, his book. I got that like years ago, and I always thought that was a dope name. I just liked it. I read it. I thought it was just a good practice. Yeah. Like, and I named it that basically. Like, as I don't really talk about it all the time on the show, but I like to remind people like how important certain things are. Necessarily, like the media or society doesn't encourage, but things that I found in my own personal life that are important, like breath.
Yeah.
It's like essential. Now you can't, if you don't have air for like a couple minutes, you die. If you have water, you can go months with water. With food, I mean, without food, you can go for hella long. But air, you need like a constant basis with your brain dies. So, like just deep breathing and all that type of, you know what I'm saying? Tuning in with yourself is important to me. So that's why I kind of named the show that, just as like an overtone of what everything's about.
I thought that, because he was talking about like prana, which is a vital life
force. Yeah.
But like music kind of has parallels to that. And naming your podcast or show
makes sense. Yeah.
That philosophy.
Yeah. I mean, you know, not totally. I know about prana. I do a little qigong and stuff like that. I practiced Tai Chi back in the day. I know about it. I'm not a master by any stretch. A lot about being professional and making it sound the way we want it to sound. I know I definitely developed as an MC, expressing my thoughts clearly, my intent, being more poetic, getting straight to the point, whatever it is. But also I think we're just a little more fearless than we were back then. Like, actually then we didn't give a fuck about anything. We just made music. Could care less with the radio, but through the process of making music professionally, we've been through the process of like looking around and being like, oh, what's the people doing? What's cool? Oh, okay. We've been through that. And now at this point, I really am back to where I was in the end of the woods. So it's almost like a complete circle of like not caring to caring to not caring. You know what I'm saying? So it's like relearning how to be fearless and not be a trip.
At this point, I definitely respect like people who have been doing it independently. Like in a major way now, like Tech N9ne, Atmosphere, well, the Latin series camp still camp, like, mm-hmm. Timberland. Like, a lot of these guys have stayed relevant over, like, the past 20 years. And that's really respectful. So. It's going cool. We got probably, like, 6 or 7 songs done. It's gonna keep on moving.
I think it's gonna be a little more emotional and a little deeper. Just from the tracks we've done so far and the way it feels thus far. It's a little more like reflective almost.
And
yeah, it's like personal, like very, very like introspective kind of. And so far, I'm sure we'll have some other type of stuff. But the other record was just like, it's like our window on the world.
Yeah.
And what's happening? Because the world's going through a lot of changes right now. So.
Sort of, it was destined to happen. I mean, anything that comes out has got like some kind of like appeal to get commercialized in a way. It's sort of like what you do with it. So you're definitely right. There is 2 sides to it. I mean, you could use the commercialization in a positive way, or it could be a negative thing too. I mean, a lot of people have been able to get out their positive message to a broader base if they've been able to go through that small hole that's been given to them. You know. To reach people, but then a lot of negative stuff has been put out on a mass scale also. So
I mean, I think commercialization started with hip hop and like back in the Sugar Hill Gang, like, yeah, so that's been going. I think if anything, the internet has leveled the playing field for artists, producers, anybody who's an artist, you know what I'm saying? Because it gives you the ability to like create a fan base and create followers or whatever, however you want to put it, just solely on the internet. You don't need any marketing or major label to do that. It's gonna just be a kid in his room doing some dope shit, puts it on the internet, and all of a sudden he's got 1 million views, and now he's got all this attention from people. I feel like it's leveled the playing field, and it's without the internet right now, the way the industry is, it would suck. It would just be whack. It would be terrible because nobody's selling records. The only thing that's doing anything.
It's crazy though, because the industry wouldn't be the way it is though.
That's true.
I can imagine if the internet didn't come out, it would probably be like a lot of people selling a lot of albums still.
That might be true.
But I mean, it still may be the same thing in terms of like what the companies are putting out, but it would just be all about it, you know, all about your CDs and that type of stuff.
I would say. Listen, first thing I would say is listen to your inner voice. Listen to yourself. That's probably like your first thought, probably your best idea. A lot of people are trained to like doubt themselves and they have that inspired thought and then they go, no, that won't work. Let me do what they're doing. You know what I'm saying? I would say trust yourself mainly. And then, I don't know, like you're the motive of your magazine is pretty much it. Just, take action. If you want to be an MC, a producer, an artist, whatever you want to do, just start doing it. Like, do it well. People say, yeah, that's weak. And everybody's telling you it's weak. It's not like you have to take that into yourself and say, I'm weak. But know that there's criticism and then there's positive feedback, and neither of them should really sway your boat. Somebody tells you you're the best ever, somebody tells you you're the worst ever. Neither of those can, like, tip you over. You have to have enough understanding and faith in yourself that you're just gonna do what you're gonna do regardless. You know what I'm saying? Prosperity, joy, inspiration, you know what I'm saying? Good ass art, happiness, happy family, like basic shit. I'm not out to like conquer the world at all. I'm out to like enjoy my life, do what I came to do and move on, you know what I'm saying? Like, I love making music, you know what I'm saying? It's a blessing to be able to do it. And I'm thankful that we've been able to do it this long. And I pray that we keep doing it until I leave the planet, you know what I'm saying?